So in this demo, we are going to talk about using the Benedicts test to examine for reducing sugars. So the Benedicts test uses what's called the Benedicts solution, which contains a copper compound. And what we're going to be examining is a redox reaction. So we're going to look for the reduction of the copper, and it's going to change color. So we're going to put 20 drops into each one of these tubes. These tubes already contain 5 milliliters of water. So I'm going to add 20 drops. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And then we're going to add 20 to this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So we have our Benedict solution. You can see it is a light blue color. We can kind of mix it around a little bit. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna have controls in this example. So we're gonna have a negative control and a positive control. So for the negative control, we're gonna just use DI water. There should be no sugar at all in this tube. This is really important to have these controls to be able to compare to your unknown samples. So a negative control is always going to be the one that doesn't have a reaction, that is just going to be using DI water. So we're gonna add 10 drops of DI water. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again, mix this up a little bit. And then my positive control is going to have a sample of something that should react. So in this case, we're gonna use 4% glucose. So I'm gonna add 10 drops of 4% glucose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have our 10 drops of glucose, and you'll notice right now, there's no reaction. This reaction actually needs heat in order to occur. So what we're gonna do is we have our hot plate set to about 100 degrees Celsius. It's not quite there yet. We're about 80 degrees Celsius, which is about where we want to be for this reaction. Anywhere between 80 and 100 should be significant. So what we'll do is we will put our test tube on a test tube holder, and we're going to stick it in here for 3 to 5 minutes. So I'm going to leave the negative one for now. I'll show you an example of what that'll look like in a second, but I want to show you the reaction for the positive control because it's really interesting. So when we put this in, it may take a little bit of time. And again, be very careful that you're not having your face anywhere near while you do this. But in this reaction, in about a minute or so, what you're gonna start to see is a color change occur. That color change is going to tell you a reaction is occurring. It's gonna start out as kind of a greenish color, and it's going to turn into a deeper red over time, because this is a very high amount of glucose. And so the higher the amount of glucose, the more you're going to see that red copper precipitate coming out of solution. So you can see varying levels of reducing sugars based on the color change that you observe. So a green color, if it stays green color after 3 to 5 minutes, that's going to be a very low amount of reducing sugar. And you can have a gradation from green to yellow to orange to red. And so if we give it a little bit more time, we'll start to see, you can actually start seeing right now, there's a development of green inside of that tube. And so that's the reaction occurring in this copper with the glucose. And you can start to see that turns a yellow color, and it's gonna continue to react. And I'm stirring it to kind of help facilitate the interactions. And you can kind of see it's starting to turn a little bit more orange, and it's going to continue to react for that full period of time. And so as it continues to react, it gets a deeper color, more copper precipitate is forming, and we'll be able to kind of visualize that reaction. So just so you can kind of see it in comparison, the color change that's occurring. So if I were to let that go for the full 3 to 5 minutes, this is what we would see. We have a very deep red orange color, And that is going to indicate a very high amount of glucose. And your negative control has no visible reaction. No visible reaction means it stays blue. The positive reaction should change color. Any color change is indicative of a reaction. The amount of color change will dictate how much reducing sugar it has. So even if it turns a little bit green, that means there's a reducing sugar. In this case, the positive control shows us the highest amount of sugar possible with that bright orange-red color change.